Class, show your love, guys. Yeah. Wonderful. So, Rohitji, we are so excited to have you here. And to start with, sir, thoda sa hum chahte hain ki aap bachon ko direct kare about what the films are, about the film festival, then we'll go with the Q&A. Over to you, sir.
How many of you heard me talking last year? That's very nice. But I will start again by saying what I did last year. Do you want me to be nice and speak all sorts of sweet things to you and tell you the same things you've heard again and again? Or with the permission of your teachers and your management, can I be honest? But you may not like it. Let's try. A lot of you, I think now, are what is, let me just figure out who I'm speaking to. How many of you are under the 10th standard? 8th, 9th, right. How many of you more than 10th standard? Cool. How many of you are from Uttarakhand? How many of you are from out of Uttarakhand? Cool. Last time I spoke to you about two journeys, I think. One was my journey and one was my friend Shah Rukh Khan's journey. So I will start by talking to you about Shah Rukh's journey, because when a man comes from Delhi with 50 rupees in his pocket and today is worth more than 6,000 crores, he's obviously done something right. Fair enough? I met him on the streets of Bombay. I was shooting with Salman Khan for a film called Patthar Ke Phool. Salman had no film released then. The heroine was a new girl called Raveena Tandon. So my assistants told me, sir, aap kone mein jaake baith lijiye because aapki ek TV serial chal rahi hai, to aap ki wajah se hamara shooting kharab ho raha hai. We were shooting on a Sunday on Linking Road, which is a very, very busy road in Bombay. So I went inside that little coffee shop, chota sa tha Bandra mein, and I was just sitting by myself and making coffee. And the waiter came to me and said, sir, वहाँ पे बहुत बड़ा टीवी स्टार बैठे हैं, उसको सिगरेट चाहिए. मैंने दे दिया. 10 मिनट बाद आया, सर उसको दूसरा सिगरेट चाहिए. मैंने दे दिया. तीसरी बार बेचारा खुद आया, थोड़ा सा शर्मिंदा था. He said, I'm sorry, I don't have cigarettes, I'm borrowing them from you. I said, you're not borrowing them from me, I don't smoke, it belongs to someone in the unit, I'm just giving them to you free. So we broke the ice, he sat down with me. We ate vada, we ate pav, we ate scrambled eggs, and we kept on eating until 6 o'clock. Then my unit came, we did the pack up, and I was on my way out. He says, where are you going? I said, I'm going to the Sterling Cinema to see a film called Abyss by James Cameron, because they've set up a new system called Dolby. He said, I'll come with you. Come. We went to the cinema, it was house full, we bought tickets in black. We saw the movie. And we came out of the theatre about 12 o'clock in the night. He says, lend me 100 rupees because I have to get back to Bandra. Now in those days there were no credit cards, cell phones, PayPal, Paytm, there was nothing. I was spending on the eggs and the vada pav. I was spending on the tickets and the popcorn. I had no money left. So I said, don't worry, get into my car. I will drive you back to Bandra. There was no petrol in the car. I said, okay, no worries. Let's go home. We'll borrow 100 rupees from my mother and then you can go home.